Thank you very much. My presentation explores the sports activity which was developed by the English commercial school Barkshire in Smyrna and Athens from its foundation in 1872 to the interwar years. This activity is part of the general context of the introduction of British sports to the Ottoman territory and Greece, as British use sports as a means of social distinction and cultural penetration in areas where British were active and where its troops were stationed. In the case of the Barkshire School, its contribution to the introduction of physical education to Smyrna School, its contact with the Greek Orthodox population of the city, and its subsequent activation in the educational context of Athens are of particular interest. The investigation of the physiognomy and the sports activity of the school was based on evidence from the press of the town, as well as on the available literature, because the school archives were destroyed during the fire of Smyrna in 1922 and during the occupation of Athens by the forces of the Axis between 1941 and 1944. During the Victorian period in England, sports were organized through the establishment of regulations and the formation of unions and institutions. Sports were introduced to schools and universities where the pupils of middle and upper classes were studying, combining the development of their personal skills with the promotion of team spirit. Sports were part of British culture and the cultural product that was exported to various regions of the world, while contributing to the promotion of British culture around the world. Smyrna was one of the most typical examples of a large Mediterranean port, where members of local European communities, the British being predominant, formed sports networks involving members of other communities, mainly members of the Greek Orthodox middle class. The sports practices followed by the British in cities such as Smyrna contributed to the creation of a national cultural identity combined with the prestige of a gentleman, chivalry and fair play. The athletic spaces that were set up functioned as prestigious zones, which on the one hand contributed to the formation of social hierarchies among the British, while on the other hand they contributed to their cultural dominance over the locals. Pioneers of sports in Smyrna were the members of the European community of the city, mostly British. In the suburb of Burnova, the British Burnova Club was dominant, including a strong football team. In 1894, the first sports games of the Burnova Athletic Club, called Panteion, were recorded. On April 23, 1896, Burnova Games took place, including 14 events, with the participation of Greek Orthodox athletes from Orpheus and Gymnasium clubs. Indicative of the influence of the British in Smyrna sports was the fact that until 1900 and the organization of the 4th Panionian Games, the measurement units for sports performance were the yard and the mile. Furthermore, sports like football were introduced to Smyrna by the British. Football made its appearance in the city through the Burnova Club, which consisted mainly of British, and gave its first games against the crews of British warships visiting the port of Smyrna. This club participated in the 1906 Middle Olympic Games in Athens and won the second place. In the 1890s, the members of the Greek Orthodox community of Smyrna, having got in touch with the city's Levantine sports, founded important sports clubs such as Panionios and Apollo. The sports competition among the city communities promoted sport through the establishment of many clubs, the introduction of games and the construction of stadiums, while the members of different ethnic groups developed ties through coexistence in the fields. The founder of the English commercial school Barkshire, William Barkshire, was born in 1839 in Reading, England. He studied ancient Greek at Cheltenham Normal College. As a graduate and lover of ancient Greece, he went to Smyrna in 1870 to set up his own school there. After being hosted by members of the local British community of the city in Budja, he founded in 1872 the homonymous English commercial school in the Greek district of Asula. Along with his educational work, William Barkshire acted as a member of the local British community and the Anglican St. John's Church. Being a fan of Greek classical education, he also dealt with archaeology, gathering several archaeological finds, which he later donated to the Museum of the Evangelical School. William Barkshire died in May 1910. After his death, the school continued to operate by his son, Charles Frederick Barkshire, also an educator in profession, born in Smyrna in 1873. Having grown up as an infant in the school, he was raised according to his father's ideals. It is characteristic that father and son were both able to recite the rhapsodies of Homer's epics from memory. The English commercial school Barkshire, with a boarding school and sports facilities, was housed in the large house of the Levantine Baptist family in Halleplea Street, which was bought by William Barkshire and turned into a school building and a family home. According to the announcement of the foundation of the school in 1872, which was published in the Smyrna Press, the purpose of the school was to provide commercial education to students as well as general education. The school's curriculum was following the Oxford and Cambridge local exam program. According to Christos Solomonidis, although the school functioned according to English standards, it acquired a Greek character and the education provided was characterized as Greek-like, so many Greeks were studying in it. Thus, the school became a major Greek nursery for young people in the Smyrna region, Asia Minor in general, and the islands. According to testimonies, in the years before 1922, wealthy families from the Eastern Aegean Islands and Cyprus chose to send their boys as intern students to the school in order to get trained for a career on trade in Smyrna or their places. The pupils would also enjoy the benefits of the British educational system on the one hand and receive classical ancient Greek education on the other. In the Journal of the Society of Arts of January 17, 1879, we find information about the school which allows us to get the full picture. In 1879, 140 students were attending school. Out of these, 35 were intern students and 30 were daily residents. Based on religion, the students included 30 Protestants, 25 Roman Catholics, 50 Greek Orthodox, 30 Armenians, and 4 Jews. The teaching staff consisted of 17 teachers of various majors. The languages taught, according to the school's curriculum, were English, French, Greek, German, Armenian, Turkish, and Latin. The courses were taught simultaneously in three languages, English, French, and Greek. During the last year of its operation, the faculty had 13 teachers and 150 students. After the Asia Minor catastrophe, the Barkshire School moved its headquarters to Athens and operated there until 1941. Physical education was introduced in 1863 as a subject of study in the higher military schools of the Ottoman Empire. In Smyrna, Greek Orthodox educational institution introduced gymnastics into their program in the last quarter of the 19th century, performing gymnastic shows and other activities, while in 1901 Panteion established the school games in Smyrna. The introduction of gymnastics in the program of the British schools in Smyrna from the early 1870s and the general sports activity of the Levantine, mainly the Brunova Sports Club, played a catalytic role in the spread of sports in the city. The Barkshire School, since its establishment in 1872, always held its annual indoor sports competitions, while its students successfully participated in the school games of Panionios. The school even had its own athletic outfit, a sports anthem, and a banner. In 1900, we read that the school had received an invitation from Panionios for the 9 to 13 year old students' games. In May 1905, the students of the school took part in Panionios' 5th school games, which took place at the Paradiso Stadium. 12 faculties of Smyrna took part in them. On behalf of the school, the following Greek pupils were to participate. In 1910, during the 10th school games of Panionios, several students of the school also distinguished. We can see the names here. At the same time, the English commercial school Barkshire had offered awards to the Panionian games at least for the years 1899, 1900, 1902, and 1904. Finally, it is worth noting that most of the schools in Smyrna maintained special football teams. The most famous ones were the teams of the Barkshire School and the Evangelical School. In January 1920, the football team of the Barkshire School defeated the Evangelical School football team for the Apollo School Games. As it can be seen by the subject taught in the school, its purpose was to provide the young people of Smyrna, the Asia Minor in general, Cyprus, and the Aegean Islands with a knowledge which was considered to be appropriate for someone in order to excel in the society of Smyrna. First, commercial knowledge. Secondly, knowledge of many languages. And thirdly, a global education in which sports were in a prominent position. The third category concerned the sports skills that a member of Smyrna middle class had to possess, which were necessary for his free time. The members of the local elite of Smyrna used to spend part of their free time on football, athletics, tennis, rowing, etc., in that way distinguishing themselves from the people of the lower classes. Therefore, the development of individual sports skills was a necessary asset for someone who wanted to distinguish themselves in the cosmopolitan society of Smyrna. This photo is very typical. In addition, Barkshire's love for the history and culture of ancient Greece seems to have been a serious motivation for them to promote sports in their school. Archaeology, moreover, was evident among the intellectuals of Smyrna during the above period. During the days of the Smyrna disaster, the school director, Charles Barkshire, opened the school gate and accepted many Greek refugees, offering them protection. It is characteristic that the courtyard was filled with refugee families whose members were fed at the expense of the school. According to testimonies, baskets of bread arrived daily at the school during the period before the catastrophe. The school was also burned down in the Great Fire, while Barkshire family members fled from Smyrna, being one of the 200 refugee British families which were transferred to Cyprus. After a short stay in Cyprus, the Barkshire family settled in Athens, where it moved the headquarters of the school. In the district of Patisia on Patmos Street, the English commercial school Barkshire continued to provide commercial training according to the British standards, again giving great weight to physical education of its students, fulfilling the annual sports games of the school and participating in school tournaments of Athens and Piraeus. Providing athletic knowledge was equally necessary for someone who wanted to distinguish themselves in the growing interwar Athenian society. Although the school complex in Athens was apparently smaller in size, it had exercise areas and a volleyball court where not only school students but also children of the neighborhood could practice. In May 1926, we read in the Athletikos Kosmos magazine that the English commercial school Barkshire would hold its annual school games, quote, which had been carried out since its establishment in Smyrna, end of quote. While in December 1926, the school's football team participated in the Athens and Piraeus School Championship, organized by Woody Club, and even receiving a prize for its appearance. Special mention was made by the press to Henriette Barkshire, the wife of the director, Charles Barkshire. At the end of the games, Mrs. Barkshire, a real sportswoman, will award the medals to the winners and offer tea. Henriette Barkshire was born in Smyrna in 1879. She was the daughter of Alphonse von Saber Ostman and Anna Filippucci of the Filippucci great Levantine family. Her father was an Austrian of French origin and went from Istanbul to Smyrna to run the Austro-Hungarian post office of the city. Her brother William was the owner of Club Saber, which had tennis courts and a leisure area near Brazil. Levantines were regular, and it was also referred as the Saber Club. It is obvious that her upbringing in such a cosmopolitan environment, where sports held a central position and constituted a way of life, justified her title in Athens as a sportswoman, a title she honored alongside her compassionate husband, Charles Barkshire. At the Barkshire School, the French-speaking Henriette found fertile ground and the right condition to engage herself in sports, a subject she knew well and loved. Reading the reports on the sports activities of the school in Athens, we realized that the annual games, as well as the ceremony of medal awards and tea offering, clearly referred to the practices and habits of the Levantines of Smyrna, which were now transferred to Athens. This was a cultural transfer, this time from Smyrna to Athens. The introduction of modern sports in Smyrna by a British educational organization is part of the general processes of the spread of modern British sports in the Eastern Mediterranean. For the British, sports were part of their culture and a way of life. This culture was spread to Smyrna, making a decisive contribution to the promotion of its sport. The English commercial school Barkshire addressed to the young people of Smyrna, Asia Minor and the Aegean Islands, providing them with the necessary knowledge to make them competitive in the Smyrna environment. First, commercial knowledge. Two, foreign language and education. And three, education, where sports had a central place. The contribution of the school to the introduction of physical education in Smyrna school should be taken for granted. The school had over time attracted many Greek students, however, retaining its British character and following the direction of British education. After the catastrophe of 1922, the school continued its operation in Athens, maintaining sports at the center of its program. In conclusion, we would say that by exploring the history of Barkshire School, we decode the appearance and evolution of physical education and sports in Smyrna, as well as the transfer of this culture later in Athens. The new ideas and new trends of the Levantines found fertile ground in Smyrna and were adopted by the Smyrnians, and after 1922, these ideas were transferred to Athens. The members of the Barkshire family were carriers of this sports culture, and the record of their contribution is further enlightening an important chapter of Smyrna Levantines activity. At this point, and before I end, I would like to thank Mrs. Noelle Baxter, the granddaughter of Charles Barkshire, because without her assistance, it would be very difficult to complete my presentation. Thank you very much.